Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvenni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. This is lecture number 9 on Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. We are going to solve problems in the isentropic flow. In the earlier lectures in the isentropic flow, we studied the governing equation for isentropic flow in nozzle and diffuser, relationship between various properties for isentropic flow, effect of area variation in the nozzle and diffuser, mass flow rate of the mass flow rate through the nozzle and diffuser, and flow characteristics in the nozzle and the diffuser. So, here we are going to solve problems from the Anna University question paper for the in the isentropic flow in nozzle and diffuser. The learning outcome to the students at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problem in the isentropic flow in nozzle and diffuser. Example number 1 from November 2003, May 2009, November 2009 and November 2013 question paper. Air is discharged from a receiver at a stagnation pressure 6.91 bar and temperature 325 degrees Celsius through a nozzle to an exit pressure of 0.98 bar. If the flow rate is 3600 kilograms per hour, determine for isentropic flow area, pressure and velocity at the throat, area and Mach number at the exit and maximum possible velocity at the outlet. So, we are given stagnation pressure PO equal to 6.91 bar. Stagnation temperature TO equal to 325 degrees Celsius, P2 equal to 0.98 bar, mass flow rate equal to 3600 kilograms per hour, which is 1 kilograms per second. For isentropic flow, PO1 equal to PO2 equal to 6.91 bar, TO1 equal to TO2, which is 325 degrees Celsius, which is 598 Kelvin. Area, pressure and velocity at the throat section. So, at the throat, Mach number equal to 1 and gamma equal to 1.4. For this condition, Mach number equal to 1, gamma equal to 1.4 from isentropic table 3.2, page number 31. We take T star by TO equal to 0.834, P star by PO equal to 0.528. Now, from this value, the properties at the throat, the pressure and temperature at the throat section, T star equal to 0.834 into TO equal to 0.834 into 598 equal to 498.7 Kelvin. P star equal to 0.528 into PO, which is 0.528 into 6.91 equal to 3.65 bar. Velocity at the throat section, C star equal to A star equal to square root of gamma R T star, which is square root of 1.4 into 287 into 498.7 equal to 447.6 meters per second. Density of the air at throat section, rho star equal to P star by R into T star, 3.65 into 10 power 5 divided by 287 into 498.7 equal to 2.5 kilograms per meter cube. Area of the throat, A star equal to mass flow rate divided by rho star into C star, 1 by 2.55 into 447.6 equal to 8.67 10 power minus 4 meter square, which is 8.67 centimeter square. Now, area and the Mach number at the exit. So, pressure ratio at the exit, P2 by PO2 equal to 0.98. So, P2 is given and PO2 is 6.91 equal to 0.14. So, P2 by PO2 equal to 0.14. Now, from the isentropic table, table number 3.2, page number 34, at the P2 by PO2 equal to 0.14 and gamma equal to 1.4, we take Mach number equal to 1.94 and T2 by TO2 equal to 0.57. So, the temperature at the exit of the nozzle, T2 equal to 0.57 into TO2, which is 0.57 into 598, equal to 340.86 Kelvin. Velocity at the outlet of the nozzle, C2 equal to M2 into square root of gamma RT2, which is 1.94 into square root of 1.4 into 287 into 340.86 equal to 718 meters per second. Density of the air at the outlet of the nozzle, Rho2 equal to P2 by R into T2, 0.98 into 10 power 5 divided by 287 into 340.86 equal to 1 kilogram per meter cube. Area of the nozzle at the exit, A2 equal to M by mass flow rate divided by Rho2 into C2, which is 1 by 1 into 0.718 equal to 1.39 in 10 power minus 3 meter square equal to 13.9 centimeter square. Maximum possible velocity, CO equal to C maximum equal to square root of 2 Cp into TO, 2 into 1005 into 598 equal to 1096.3 meters per second. Answer to the problem, area, pressure and velocity at the throat section, A star equal to 8.76 centimeter square, P star equal to 3.65 bar, C star equal to 447.6 meters per second, area and the Mach number at the exit, A2 equal to 13.9 centimeter square and M2 equal to 1.94, maximum possible velocity 1096.3 meters per second. Example number 2 from May 2014 question paper, air flows down a variable area duct. Measurement indicate that temperature is 278 Kelvin and velocity is 150 meters per second at certain section of, on the duct. Measurement at the second section indicate that the temperature decreased to 253 Kelvin. Assuming that the flow is adiabatic and one dimensional, find the velocity at the second section. So, we are given T1 equal to 278 Kelvin, C1 equal to 150 meters per second and T2 equal to 253 Kelvin. Mach number at the section 1, M1 equal to C1 divided by square root of gamma RT1, 150 divided by square root of 1.4 and 287 into 278 equal to 0.45. At M1 equal to 0.45 and gamma equal to 1.4 from isentropic table 3.2 page number 29. So, T1 by T01 equal to 0.961. So, T01 stagnation temperature equal to T1 by 0.961 equal to 278 divided by 0.961 equal to 289.3 Kelvin. So, the stagnation temperature is 289.3 Kelvin. And the temperature ratio at the section 2, T2 by T02 equal to 253 divided by 289.3 which is 0.874. Now, using the isentropic table, page 3.2, page number 34, at T2 by T02 equal to 0.874 and gamma equal to 1.4, M2 equal to 0.85. So, the velocity at the section 2, C2 equal to M2 into square root of gamma RT2, which is 0.85 into square root of 1.4 into 287 into 253 equal to 271 meters per second. So, velocity at the section, the answer to the problem, velocity at the section 2 equal to 271 meters per second. Example number 3 from May 2004 and November 2013 question paper, a certain quantity of air at a pressure of 3.344 bar and temperature 627 degrees Celsius is flowing through a convergent-divergent nozzle. The exit pressure is 1.05 bar. Determine the temperature, velocity and density of the air at the exit. Also determine pressure, temperature, density and velocity of the air at exit if the divergent portion is to act as a diffuser. Assume isentropic flow in both cases. So, we are given P01 equal to 3.344 bar, T01 equal to 627 degree Celsius which is 900 Kelvin and P2 equal to 1.05 bar. Pressure ratio at the exit of the CD nozzle. P2 by PO2 equal to 1.05 divided by 3.344 equal to 0.314. So, from isentropic table 3.2 page number 32 at P2 by PO2 equal to 0.314 and gamma equal to 1.4, we take M2 equal to 1.4, T2 by TO2 equal to 0.718, A2 by A star equal to 1.115. Now, we calculate the pressure, temperature, velocity, density of the air at exit. So, T2 equal to 0.718 into T02 equal to 0.718 into 900 equal to 646.2 Kelvin. C2 equal to M2 into square root of gamma RT2, 1.4 into square root of 1.4 into 287 into 646.2 equal to 713.4 meters per second. Density rho2 equal to P2 by RT2, 1.05 into 10 power 5 divided by 287 into 646.2 equal to 0.566 kilograms per meter cube. If the divergent portion acts as a diffuser, so for the, now from the isentropic table 3.2 page number 30 at A2 by A star equal to 1.155 and gamma equal to 1.4. So, this A2 by A star value already we have taken from the previous Mach number, A2 by A star equal to 1.155 for the same area ratio. Now, we take the property for the same area ratio. Now, we take the property on the subsonic region because when it is acting as a diffuser, so the Mach number will be less than 1 and the pressure will increase. The divergent portion pressure will increase. Now, using the same area ratio, we have to refer the same table but in the subsonic region. So, earlier we referred to the supersonic region. Now, we have to refer to the subsonic region. M2 equal to 0.673. So, T2 by TO2 equal to 0.9163. P2 by PO2 equal to 0.738. Now, temperature, velocity and density of the air at exit. So, T2 equal to 0.9163 into TO2 equal to 0.9163 into 900 equal to 824.67 Kelvin. And the P2 equal to 0.732 into PO2, which is 0.732 into 3.344 equal to 2.47 bar. Velocity C2 equal to M2 into square root of gamma RT2, which is 0.673 into square root of 1.4 into 287 into 824.67 equal to 387.4 meters per second. Density at the outlet P2 by RT2, rho 2 equal to P2 by RT2 equal to 2.47 10 power 5 divided by 287 into 624.67 equal to 1.04 kilogram per metric cube. The answer to the problem, temperature, velocity and density of the air at exit, T2 equal to 646.2 Kelvin, C2 equal to 713.4 meters per second and rho 2 equal to 0.566 kilograms per meter cube. If the divergent portion act as a diffuser, the pressure P2 equal to 2.47 bar, T2 equal to 824.67 Kelvin, C2 equal to 387.4 meters per second and density equal to 1.04 kilogram per meter cube. Example number 4 from November 2006 question paper. The pressure, velocity, temperature of isentropic flow of air at an entry of a nozzle are 2 bar 150 meters per second and 330 Kelvin. The exit pressure is 1.5 bar. Determine the shape of the nozzle. If the Mach number at the entry and the exit of the nozzle, mass flow rate through the nozzle, you take gamma equal to 1.4 and Cp equal to 1 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin for air. Now we are given P1 equal to 2 bar, C1 equal to 150 meters per second, T1 equal to 330 Kelvin and P2 pressure at the outlet of the nozzle is 1.5 bar, gamma equal to 1.4, Cp equal to 1. So gas constant for the air, so R equal to Cp into gamma minus 1 by gamma, 1000 into 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 equal to 286 joules per kilogram Kelvin. The Mach number at the entry of the nozzle, M1 equal to C1 divided by square root of gamma RT1, which is 150 divided by 1.4 into 286 into 330 equal to 0.41. Now, density of the air at the entry, rho 1 equal to P1 by RT1, which is 2 into 10 power 5 divided by 286 into 330 equal to 2.12 kilograms per meter cube. Now, for the Mach number equal to 0.41 and gamma equal to 1.4 from isentropic table 3.2, page number 29, you take the property ratio T1 by TO1 equal to 0.967, P1 by PO1 equal to 0.891. So, the stagnation properties of the nozzle. So, TO1 equal to T1 divided by 0.967, which is 330 divided by 0.967 equal to 343.4 Kelvin. PO1 equal to P1 by 0.891 equal to 2 divided by 0.891 equal to 2.24 bar. And the pressure ratio at the exit. So, P2 by PO2 equal to 1.5 divided by 2.24 equal to 0.67. Now, for this pressure ratio, again from the isentropic table 3.2, page number 30, for the pressure ratio P2 by PO2 equal to 0.67 and gamma equal to 1.4, M2 equal to 0.68. Now, the mass flow rate per unit area, M equal to rho 1 A1 C1, 2.12 into area equal to 1 meter square into 150 equal to 318 kilogram per meter square second. The answer to the problem, shape of the nozzle is subsonic because inlet Mach number and exit Mach number both are less than 1. So, the subsonic flow, Mach number M1 equal to 0.41, M2 equal to 0.78, mass flow rate through the nozzle equal to 318 kilogram per meter square second. Example number 5, a rocket has an area ratio of A2 by A star equal to 3.5 for the nozzle. The total pressure is 50 bar. The propellant is being burnt at the rate of 45 kilograms per second and the stagnation temperature is 2500 degrees Celsius. What should be the exit and the throat areas? This is from November 2009 question paper. We are given A2 by A star equal to 3.5, PO2 equal to 50 bar, mass flow rate equal to 45 kilograms per second. TO2 equal to 2500 degrees Celsius, which is 2773 Kelvin. From isentropic table, table number 3.2, page number 37, for the area ratio A2 by A star equal to 3.5 and gamma equal to 1.4, we take the properties M2 equal to 2.8, T2 by TO2 equal to 0.389, P2 by PO2 equal to 0.0369. So, the pressure, temperature, velocity, density of the air at the exit. So we calculate P2 equal to 0.0369 into PO2, which is 0.0369 into 50 equal to 1.845 bar. T2 equal to 0.389 into TO2, which is 0.389 into 2773 equal to 1078.7 Kelvin. C2 equal to M2 into square root of gamma RT2, 2.8 into 1.4, square root of 1.4 into 287 into 1078.7 equal to 1843.4 meters per second. And rho 2 equal to P2 by RT2, 1.845 into 10 power 5 divided by 287 into 1078.7 equal to 0.266 kilograms per meter cube. The exit area of the rocket nozzle, A2 equal to M by rho 2 C2, 45 divided by 0.266 into 1843.4 equal to 0.0918 meter square, which is 918 centimeter square. Throat area of the rocket nozzle, so A star equal to A2 by 3.5, 918 divided by 3.5 equal to 262.3 centimeter square. The answer to the problem, exit area equal to 918 centimeter square, throat area equal to 262.3 centimeter square. So we stop here. So these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject. There is one book, Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. You can refer to the book for additional problems in the isentropic flow. I upload the video lectures of all the subjects mentioned here in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. We will continue with the problem solving in the isentropic flow in the next video lecture also.